Good evening, everyone. I'm Keith Allen here. I am once again your host for this evening. I had been looking forward to this evening, and I hope you, like me, have been looking forward to the power that will come from our evangelist, Pastor Mario Phillip. He took us on a journey Friday evening. He gave us a scintillating program Saturday. And now we have assembled for another session. I know that he has a tremendous amount of blessings in store for us this evening. And so I want to take the opportunity in welcoming our guests again. Our friends from Pakistan, we wish to welcome you. Those who are from the Caribbean and Africa, we want to extend a very special welcome to you. Not to forget our guest here from the United Kingdom. We are privileged to have you. Together, we want to experience the power tonight. Now, I want to remind you that you need to continue to invite your friends and your family members. Remember now, there is a special gift for you at the end of the program. Anyone who has brought the most guests, and those who have attended the most nights, we have a very special gift for you. And so we want you to complete the registration form on the website. Do not forget to do that. We also want to invite you to make your notes, because you will be invited to complete the quiz. The quiz that you were introduced to on Friday night, we want you to continue to complete that quiz. And again, we have a very special prize awaits you. Now, the prize will not be given to incomplete quiz. So remember to complete it and to get it right. So make your notes tonight so that you will be able to complete the quiz. As usual, we will begin our program with a short video. And this video is entitled Renewing the Heart. Renewing the Heart. So please sit back and enjoy this very special short video clip.
Today's health spot is renewing the heart. The heart is a muscle that contracts continuously and pumps blood throughout the body. The pumping action is caused by a flow of electricity powered by the cardiac conduction system. The cardiac conduction system consists of the sinoatrial node, which is located in the right atrium of your heart, the atrial ventricle node, located on the intraatrial septum close to the tricuspid valve, and the Purkinje system, located along the walls of your heart's ventricles. The heart beats 100,000 times a day, pumps 2,000 gallons of blood, carried around a network of vessels the distance of 60,000 miles. The heart has two sides, separated by an inner wall called the septum. The right side of the heart pumps blood to the lungs to pick up oxygen. The left side of the heart receives oxygen-rich blood and pumps it to the body. It is the hardest working organ in your body, yet the valves that constantly open and shut do not wear down. There are many factors that influence how the heart functions, which include environment, diet, activity, and mental state. Low-density lipoprotein, or LDL, is produced because of stress and tissue damage. A person with high LDL means that their environment causes cortisol levels to rise, and cortisol is responsible for inhibiting insulin. Tissue damage can also occur through exercise, diet, or mental state. Statin drugs are widely prescribed to lower LDL, and the medical community prescribed them to certain age groups because they lead to heart disease and cardiac anomalies. They are often kept away from older ages, people with a risk of cardiovascular disease, and several other factors. Some practices now know to examine the physical, chemical, and emotional factors of a patient because LDL is a contributor to those factors. High blood pressure is an adaptation by the body to compensate for a change in diet, circumstance, or mental state. Normal blood pressure readings are 120 over 80, but this number should not be used for everyone in all situations, circumstances, and age groups. High blood pressure is a reading on a device and should be read in relation to the state of mind. The heart is self-regulating, and controlling the heart with statins only leads to advanced health issues in the future. Oxygen transportation is vital for healthy tissue, and that is the function of the heart. When you yawn, that's the body's backup mechanism to get more oxygen into the blood. That's why it's a good idea to practice deep breathing, as the body needs oxygen in the brain, kidneys, heart, and other organs to keep you healthy. Peripheral chemoreceptors monitor chemical changes within the blood. The carotid and aortic bodies, respectively, are closely situated on the neck and heart. They monitor oxygen, carbon dioxide, and glucose levels. Yawns are usually a trigger from one of those sensors. Nutrients that help the heart include omega-3 fatty acids. They combat high cholesterol, anxiety, and many other symptoms. Omega-3 is mainly found in seeds like flax, chia, hemp, sunflower, pumpkin, and others. Quercetin is a natural antioxidant that is found mainly in apples. Other sources are peppers, dark cherries, and berries, just to name a few. Folate is a water-soluble B vitamin, and since it cannot be stored in your body, it should be consumed every day. Folate sources can be found in dark leafy greens, broccoli, citrus fruits, and beans. Monounsaturated fats help reduce bad cholesterol levels and provide nutrients to help develop and maintain your body's cells. Avocados are a good source. Magnesium increases energy, relieves muscle aches and spasms, and regulates calcium, potassium, and sodium. These are just a few that are beneficial elements for increasing heart health. The purpose for a healthy heart is to secure the highest development of body, mind, and soul. The laws of nature, being the laws of God, are designed for our good, that obedience to them promotes happiness in this life and aids in the preparation for the life to come.
Your praise for your time, such a marvelous thing for someone so wretched, yet my soul you have.
Oh, Let us pray. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Our sovereign God, our heavenly Father, we worship and adore you. We praise your holy name. We thank you that we can access your throne room of grace at this time, made possible through your Son, Christ Jesus, who loved us so much that he died for us. And did not leave us comfortless, but promised us the Holy Spirit, who will present our prayers before you as sweet incense. We thank you for everyone who is listening, all our viewers this evening. We pray that you will bless them, and as they listen, that they will really enjoy this experience of power this evening. We pray for the preacher, that you will anoint him. As he studied to present your word, we pray that now that he presents the word that you give him, that the Holy Spirit will anoint him, his head, his brains, his mouth, so that he speaks with clarity, power, and holy boldness. As the truth is revealed to us, you promise, Lord, to guide us into all truth. So as we hear that truth, may your Holy Spirit prompt us to accept the truth. Make us pliable and flexible in your hand, and may the Holy Spirit guide us into all truth. We thank you for this opportunity you have given us, that we can learn more of you. We pray that Jesus Christ will be high and lifted up, because you said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. So, Father, hear our prayer this evening. We ask that as the Holy Spirit present the word through Pastor, that as in days of old, what happened with Peter will happen to us. As they heard the word, the Holy Spirit fell upon them. Lord, hear our prayer this evening. Forgive us of our sins, we pray, so that as we worship you and experience the power, indeed, it will impact our lives. We are mindful that there are some people who, because of COVID-19, Lord, they have many challenges. Whether it be emotional, whether it be physical, you promise, because you are Jehovah Jireh, you will provide for all our needs. Help us to consider the lilies and the birds. You provided for them. And Lord, if you give your Son, which you did, you said you will freely give us all things. And so we claim that promise. And now we wait upon you, Lord. Bless us so that we would leave this experience with power this evening. As we listen to your word, you said your word will not return to you void. And so we wait upon you. Grant us that hope, that joy, and that peace, which comes only from knowing you. And Lord, hear us, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Temple, you are the voice, we are your song.
You are a God, we are your people. You are the light, we stand in awe. We stand in awe of you. We stand. Darkness into your love, into your light. Grace upon grace, beauty for ashes. You come to us, we come alive. We stand.
Good evening to all of you. Thank you for tuning in to another edition, another episode of Experience the Power. We are so glad for those of you who have joined us for the past 2 days, and we know that you have been having a great time in the Lord. I want to join in welcoming all our visiting friends who are with us. Those of you who've been with us since Friday night, we want to welcome you. And to those who are joining for the very first time tonight, we also would like to say a special welcome to you. We want you to know that this series continues every evening at 7:15. So invite your friends, share the link, and most importantly, you be here so that you can experience the blessing of the Lord. Tomorrow evening, we have another exciting message for you. Our message tomorrow evening will be experience the power of your testimony. Experience the power of your testimony. Tonight, however, we will be looking at the topic caption, experience the power of the gospel. Experience the power of the gospel. Let us pray. Father in heaven, tonight as we come before you, we thank you for another opportunity to share this gospel with your people. May they indeed experience the power that comes from knowing the gospel. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Experience the power of the gospel. The occasion was the day of Pentecost. Peter and the disciples had just received an outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon them. And they were filled with the Holy Spirit. Peter, under the influence of the Holy Spirit, preached one message. And that one message yielded over 3,000 souls for the Lord. It means, therefore, that you don't have to hear much. Tonight, you can hear one message and decide to follow Jesus. The one who will enable you to make a decision for Jesus is the Holy Spirit. And so tonight, as you listen to this message, this may just be the one message that you will hear that will cause you to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. And so Peter, standing on the day of Pentecost, under the conviction of the Holy Spirit, decided and began to preach the gospel. There is power in the gospel. The gospel simply means good news. There is so much bad news in this world. Sometimes it is discouraging to turn on the television. Yes, even to read the newspaper. You may be wondering sometimes, what's next? Tonight, I've got news for you. I've got good news for you. It's called the Evangelion. Yes, it's called the gospel. The gospel is the good news of Jesus. And so Peter, in Acts chapter 2, began to preach the gospel. And I want to read for you from the book of Acts chapter 2, reading from verse 22, Peter, preaching to the multitude, said, "Men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God with mighty works and wonders and signs that God through him in your midst, as you yourself know, this Jesus, yes, delivered up according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God, you crucified and killed by the hands of lawless men. God raised him up, loosing the pangs of death, because it was not possible for him to be held by it, referring to death. I saw the Lord always before me, for he is at my right hand, that I may not be shaken. Therefore, my heart was made glad, and my tongue rejoiced. My flesh will also dwell in hope, for you will not abandon my soul to Hades, or let your Holy One see corruption. You have made me know the path of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. We are talking about the gospel tonight. Brothers, I may say to you with confidence from the patriarch David that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us today. Being therefore a prophet, and knowing that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke about the resurrection of Jesus, that he would not abandon to Hades, nor did his flesh see corruption. This Jesus God raised up, and of that we are all witnesses, being therefore exalted at the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit, he has poured out this that you yourself are seeing and hearing. Tonight, brethren, I want you to know there is power in the gospel of Jesus. And as I look at the message of Peter, what a message tonight. I cannot improve on this message. Yes, Peter said, Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested by God. I've come by to let somebody know tonight that Jesus is still God. I know there are many religions in this world that have people that they have deified and even placed up in the place of a religious figure that is adored. But I don't care who people have put in place or as the potentate of their religion. I've come by to let you know tonight that Jesus of Nazareth, he has been tested and proven. Peter said he is attested by God. You see, there are some gods in this world, they have hands, but they cannot touch. They have feet, and they cannot walk. They have eyes, but they cannot see. Tonight, I want you to know that there was a man called Jesus of Nazareth. They tell me the tomb is still empty. Jesus of Nazareth, attested by God. The gospel is still about Jesus. He is still the sweetest name above all other names. I don't know, there are some people that choose to deny the name of Jesus. There are some people who choose to doubt that he always or that he ever did exist. Well, I cannot convince the skeptic. I don't know what to tell the atheist. I can only tell you tonight, he lives within my heart. I've come by tonight to tell someone that Jesus of Nazareth is still alive. We are serving Jesus. Yes, Jesus, Jesus, the sweetest name. Tonight, don't be afraid of Jesus of Nazareth. He once walked the dusty streets of Nazareth. This Jesus of Nazareth, he was a man, but he was not only man. He was fully God. Yes, he became God in human flesh. This Jesus of Nazareth, tonight, I've come by to let you know that he once walked on water, gave sight to the blind. Talk to Jairus, and Jairus will tell you that he had a daughter who once died at the age of 12 until she met Jesus of Nazareth. Talk to the woman who had an issue of blood, and she will tell you for 12 years, no doctor could have cured her. But then she met Jesus of Nazareth. Talk to blind Bartimaeus. He will tell you that no optician could have cured his eyes. He was blind, but thank God he met Jesus. Talk to the man who was lame at the pool of Bethesda. For 38 years, he could not walk. But then he met Jesus of Nazareth. This Jesus of Nazareth, he once went to the tomb of Lazarus, who was dead for 4 days. And Jesus said, Lazarus, come forth. I don't know if you have met Jesus as yet, but tonight, if you have not met him, I present to you Jesus. He is the water of life. He is the bread of life. He can take your mourning and turn it into joy. I want to present you tonight, Jesus. He is the way. He is the life. No man can come to the Father except through Jesus. Tonight, I don't know about you, but oh, test and see that the Lord is good. If you have not met Jesus as yet, tonight is your night. Peter said, Jesus of Nazareth, this Jesus, verse 23 of Acts chapter 2, was delivered up according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God. God decided that he was going to become one of us. That's the message of the gospel tonight. That God had a plan to save you and to save me. The message of the gospel tonight is that Jesus, who is God, became man based upon the definite plan of God. Tonight, there are religions in this world where the gods abandon those who are serving them. They go on a holiday and leave their devotees behind. Jesus, the God of this universe, he became one of us to save us. The Apostle Peter says he was not just delivered up, but he was crucified and killed. Yes, Jesus died. The gospel tonight tells us that the God of the universe, Jesus Christ, he died for us. I've come by tonight to let you know that your sins have been paid for. Jesus paid it all. All to him you owe. Sin has left the crimson stain. He washes white as snow. Tonight, Jesus died for you. No one else died for you. No one else could have died for you. But Jesus died for you. And because he died for you, you don't have to die the death that you deserve, because Jesus took your place. This Jesus of Nazareth, he was crucified. Crucified. But the Bible said God raised him up, because the debt The grave could not hold him. Tonight, brethren and visiting friends, we have a message to share to the world that we serve a God who became man, lived like us. He was crucified. He was buried. But the story did not end in the grave. We are told that bright and early on the first day of the week, the angel left the portals of heaven, came gushing down on this earth, cried with a loud voice, Jesus, your Father calleth thee. And the Bible said that he came out of the grave, burst the chains of death, and he came out triumphantly because he is the resurrection and the life. Today, as Christians, we are not serving a dead God. Abraham, as faithful as he was, Abraham is dead. And Abraham will await the resurrection of Jesus. David is dead. All the great prophets are dead, and they are still dead. I don't know about you, but Muhammad is as good as he was. Muhammad has died and is still dead. Buddha is still dead. Hare Krishna. Yes, all the great sages of the ancient days have died, and they are still dead. Haile Selassie is dead. But I've come by to let you know that Jesus was dead. And the Bible tells me not only was he dead, but he is alive today. That's the only God that died and conquered death. And today, the gospel message tonight is that we serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. We know that he is living, whatever men may say. The gospel is good news. It's the news of Jesus, the one who died. Peter declared that message with such boldness on the day of Pentecost. He declared the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. The gospel message has its foundation in the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. Jesus lived. He died, but he was resurrected. This tells me today that it doesn't matter who you are. If you choose Jesus, one day death cannot and will not hold your body down. The grave will not and cannot hold you down. Because if Jesus conquered the death, you too can conquer the grave. And I want to thank God tonight that the gospel gives us hope, hope beyond the grave, that if Jesus conquered life and death, so too. And so tonight, not only did Jesus conquer the grave, but he lived a sinless life. He lived a life without sin. First Peter chapter 2 and verse 22 says, he committed no sin, neither was deceit found in his mouth. Jesus, what an impeccable character. What a model for us to follow tonight. A sinless life. Indeed, Isaiah chapter 53 and verse 9 says, he had done no violence. Yes, Jesus was such a model of righteousness. He was such a model of what it means to be right and just. He lived the life that we should live. He showed us that it is possible through the help of God to do what is right. And so the gospel today gives us hope that we can live like Jesus. Not only that, the gospel tells us today that Jesus has paid the penalty for your sins. He paid the ultimate price for your sins. Tonight, believers, and those of you listening to me, I've come by with good news for you tonight. That the God of the universe, Jesus is his name, he is Lord of all. Because he conquered death, everything falls subject to his domain. Indeed, Matthew chapter 28 and verse 18 says, all authority is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Jesus is Lord Supreme. There is no other God like Jesus. If you don't know Jesus tonight, I've come by to let you know he is your Lord. He is your Master. He is your Savior. He is your Redeemer. He is your soon coming King. He's the one who died for you. He's the one who created you. Tonight he loves you. He wants to save you. And that's why you need to accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. He is Lord, not just of the universe, but he is Lord of your life. The songwriter says, King of my life, I crown thee now. He is the King of your life. Tonight, I've come by to let you know that Jesus is not only Lord, but he is your Redeemer and Savior. He created you once, and then we went astray. Thank God he came and he bought us back a second time through his death on the cross. Jesus, he did everything that was required to save his people. John chapter 19 and verse 30, the Bible says, and when he had received the sour wine, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and gave up his spirit. It is finished. Jesus paid it all. Tonight, no one has any right being lost. No one has any business being lost because Jesus paid it all. It is finished. You don't have to try to save yourself. You don't have to try to do anything for yourself. What you need to do is to accept Jesus and let him save you. Let him redeem you. He has already paid it. You don't have to pay a dime. Jesus has already paid the penalty for your sins. And that's why tonight you need to accept him as your Lord and Savior. I've come by tonight to let someone know that salvation comes through Jesus. It does not come through any other means but through Jesus. The Bible said in John chapter 14 and verse 6, I am the way and the truth and the life. No man comes to the Father except through me. Yes, tonight, beloved, I've come by to tell somebody that Jesus is still the way. Jesus is still the life. You cannot get to heaven except you go through Jesus. I know there are some people who are planning to go to heaven without wanting to commit to Jesus. Well, if you are thinking of heaven, you better think about Jesus because he is the way. You got to accept him tonight. Make him your Lord. He has already died for you. Hallelujah. The Bible said in John chapter 14 and verse 3, he says, that is Acts chapter 4 and verse 12. It says, neither is there salvation in anyone else, for there is no name under heaven whereby you might be saved. You must be saved today. It doesn't matter who guru or what religious system you follow. It is either Jesus or nothing at all. There is no other name. Tonight, someone needs to call on the name of Jesus. It doesn't matter who you are. If you ought to be saved, you must do it through Jesus. The Bible said there is salvation in no other name than the name of Jesus. What a name. He is also called the Lion of the tribe of Judah. He is also called the Alpha and the Omega. He is called the first and the last, the beginning and the end, the rose of Sharon, the lily of the valley. I'm talking to you today about the great I am, the one who was, the one who is, and the one who shall forever be. Today, I don't know about you, but the name of Jesus, how sweet that name. You cannot be saved without accepting Jesus. No other man can save you. That's why tonight, if you have not yet accepted Jesus, this is your moment to accept him as your Lord and personal Savior. Because not only did Jesus live on this earth, not only did he die, not only was he resurrected, the Apostle Peter tells us, and now, I'm reading from Acts chapter 2, verses 33, he is exalted at the right hand of God. So Jesus is now in heaven, making intercession for you. He is your lawyer. He is your advocate. He is your judge. Let me tell you something. Jesus is your everything. If you have only Jesus, you've got everything. He created you. He redeemed you. He came, he died for you. Then now he's still in heaven, interceding your cause before the Father. What more do you want him to do tonight? What more can he do for you? You got to accept him tonight. Young man tonight, young woman, there is this mother tonight, this father. You need to accept Jesus tonight. Give him your life. He has done everything possible to save you tonight. And tonight, because of what Jesus has done, he has given you the assurance of the forgiveness of your sins. In fact, it doesn't matter what you have done. John chapter 1 verse 29 says, "Behold the Lamb of God, Jesus, who takes away the sin of the world." Today, I don't care how dark your sins may be, Jesus can take them away. What can wash away your sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make you pure within? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is that flow that cleanseth white as snow. Tonight, I want you to know that the blood of Jesus can still cleanse us from every sin. He says he's able to forgive if we confess our sins. 1 John chapter 1 and verse 9. He's faithful and just. And so tonight, forgiveness is available. Not only is forgiveness available, but he promises that he can give you his righteousness. Yes, tonight you may come to Jesus just as you are. Yes, you may come to him broken, battered, wounded. I know tonight you might be feeling so sorry for yourself. You might be feeling so worthless. You may be feeling so insignificant. You may have done things that have brought embarrassment and shame to yourself, to your family. Tonight, I've got hope for you that the blood of Jesus, he specializes in taking people who are covered with sins, and he is able to cover you with his righteousness. Tonight, Jesus can give you his robe of righteousness. He can take your sin-stained life and give you his life of righteousness. Tonight, Jesus can cover you with his life. And when he covers you, he no longer sees your sins, but he sees his righteousness. That's why the songwriter says, cover with his life, whiter than snow. It doesn't matter what you've done tonight. You can receive the righteousness of Jesus. Not only does he give you his righteousness, but he gives you his peace. Tonight, your mind may be troubled. Someone out there, you may be wondering, how can I find peace? Tonight, I've got news for you. The Bible said in Romans chapter 5 and verse 1, verses 1 and 2, therefore, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God. Tonight, God wants to give you peace. This peace cannot be found outside of God tonight. He wants to give you peace. Peace that passeth all understanding. Tonight, God wants to give you peace of mind. You can go to bed tonight and sleep like a baby in Jesus. You can go to bed tonight and don't be bothered by what you have done. Tonight, the power of the gospel says that Jesus can take you just as you are, and he can cover you with his righteousness, and he can put within you his Holy Spirit. I love what Peter said here. He did not finish a sermon as yet. He says, not only is Jesus sitting at the right hand of God, but having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit, he has poured it out. So tonight, Jesus wants to give you the Holy Spirit. What can change you tonight is the Holy Spirit. I'm convinced tonight that no sermon can change you. It is the Holy Spirit. And I believe tonight that the Holy Spirit is taking the words of this message, and he is moving through the homes listening to this message. The Holy Spirit can bring conviction because the power of the gospel is rested and dependent upon the Holy Spirit. So tonight, I thank God that there is power in the Holy Spirit to change life. The gospel tonight not only gives you the gift of the Holy Spirit, but the Bible said in Acts chapter 2, verse 38, repent. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus, for the forgiveness of sin, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Tonight, if you have not yet repented of your sins, Jesus is calling upon you tonight, repent. You don't need to hear two messages. This message is sufficient. If you know you have not yet given your life to Jesus, tonight is the night. The Holy Spirit is saying, based upon the authority of God, repent from your sins. Turn from your sins. Come to Jesus tonight, and he can clean you up as you give your life to him. Tonight, there is someone listening to this message who need to give their life to the Lord. You have been running away from the Lord for too long. You have wandered far away from the Lord. Tonight, you got to come back to Jesus. He got a brand new life for you tonight. Come back to him. He wants to fill you with the Holy Spirit. He wants to empower you so that you can live a brand new life. Tonight, Jesus wants to give you eternal life. And that's why I want to end with John chapter 3, verse 16. The Bible said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever speaks to every boy, every girl, every young person, every adult, white, black, Asian, Caribbean, Africans, it doesn't matter who you are tonight, British, whoever you are tonight, whosoever receive him, God can give you eternal life tonight. Tonight is your night to accept Jesus. Tonight is your night to follow Jesus. Tonight is your night to repent of your sins. This may be your very first message tonight. You may have just bumped into this stream by accident, but the Holy Spirit is speaking to you right now, and he's saying to you, repent. Give me your heart. Surrender to me tonight. I can change you. I can give you a new start. Tonight is your new beginning. Tonight. Why not accept him tonight? This Jesus who walked on the dusty streets of Palestine, he has sent the Holy Spirit tonight so that you can experience the power of the gospel. There is someone tonight who has listened to this message who need to give Jesus their life. You may be a young person, young people. You are not too young. You might be aged and you may have lived your life and wondering, what can I do? Tonight, you can follow Jesus. There is a baptism that is planned in 1 week's time. We want you to know that you can be in that number. You can make a new start with the Lord. Tonight is your night to give your life to the Lord. Why not give Jesus your life tonight? Tonight, yes, the Holy Spirit wants to come into your life like the rushing of a mighty wind. He wants to come and fill your heart tonight. Why not give him your life tonight? At this time, I want someone, anyone who is listening, that the Holy Spirit is speaking to. There is a decision card that is posted in the chat on the stream. Why not sign that up right now? Right now, as I'm waiting for you, sign up that chat right now, that card right now. Submit that card to us and take the first step in giving your life to the Lord. God is calling you to accept him tonight. Why not do it right now? Father in heaven, as your people are making decisions for you, please, oh God, accept the acts of confession. Accept the acts of repentance. Tonight, oh God, save your people. May your Holy Spirit move tonight like he did on the day of Pentecost. And may someone tonight cry out, I surrender all. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. Tonight, oh God, save someone tonight, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you.
Pastor Phillip, thank you so much for such a powerful presentation on experiencing the power of the gospel. You've told us that the gospel of Jesus Christ is the good news. We were reminded that we serve a risen Savior. Yes, he was dead, but he has been resurrected and he's now alive and well. And one day, you've reminded us, one day he is coming back for us to take us to glory with him. And this is the good news that we have heard from you tonight. What a wonderful, powerful presentation tonight. Friends, I hope, like me, you have been richly blessed. I want to remind you about the quiz. I hope you have been taking your notes and you have taken plenty of notes ready to complete the quiz. Remember now, the quiz will be marked and all correct quiz will be awarded a prize. And that prize will be given to you sometimes after the end of the campaign. But I know that you will be getting the quiz right tonight. Not only tonight, but every other night. I promise I will ask the pastor to set a very easy quiz so that everyone will get it right tonight. Friends, I want to invite you to come back tomorrow night. Remember to invite your friends. Invite your family members. Let them come and enjoy some of the good things that you have been enjoying. Until tomorrow night, may God richly bless you. Thank you and good night.
Bringing hope to a hopeless world, bringing life to a lifeless soul, giving breath to the dying, waving tears.